Just about non-violence in Islam is very rare, and I didn't get the chance to learn about it except when I came here and I had the time to read more about Islam and religion, and I would like to share with you my problems. Concept of nonviolence in itself. And there are many definitions for nonviolence. The one I would like to share is Jin Sharp's definition. And Jin Sharp is a known scholar of nonviolence, and his work focused more on Gandhi and his use of nonviolence in India's struggle against colonialism. Jin Sharp defined nonviolence as methods of protest, resistance, and intervention without physical violence, in which the members of a nonviolent group do or refuse to do certain things. They may commit acts of omission, they refuse to perform acts which they usually perform, are expected to, by custom to perform, or not required by law to perform. For acts of commission, they might perform acts which they usually do not perform, are not expected by custom to perform, or are forbidden by law to perform. Combination of both. Another definition of nonviolence is that it's an extra institutional actions pursued by organized civic forces in the form of not using violence. It usually takes the form of preaching, either protest and persuasion, non-cooperation, or nonviolent intervention. Well, many people confuse nonviolence with pacifism. But actually, from these actions, it could be seen that nonviolence is actually an active action, where people perform or reject to perform a certain action. Academics and scholars view nonviolence as not just a moral issue, it's not just a concept that is derived from religion, but it's also a strategic action that is used in order to achieve certain aims. What's interesting is that in Islam, nonviolence is not just a moral action, but it's also seen as a strategic action, and that's why I'm trying to explain more in my presentation. As in yesterday's yesterday's session, there were two views. Like presenters said that there are two views on religion. Some people see that religions inside violence. The more religious people tend to be, the more violent they are, the more conservative, the more they reject the other because they are different, they don't believe in what they believe in. And others see us that religion actually is a source of peace, that there is no religion on earth that supports violence.